today we'll continue to talk about strings. Today we'll talk about Aho Corasick algorithm. What the problem will be solved today? The problem is, again, we'll talk about substring search, but slightly different. So again, we'll have some text. So text is just a long string. So we have some long string T. And we have many small strings. So we have strings S1, S2, S3, and so on. And what we want to do is to find all the strings in the text. And for each string, we want to find the substring of T, which is equal to S. So how can you solve this problem? Again, you can just run any, basically, of the substring search algorithms we discussed in previous lectures. So you can run Knuth-Morris path algorithm, you can run Z algorithm, or any other algorithm we discussed earlier. So you can just take each string S, and for each string just run any substring search algorithm. All of them work in linear time, so you will spend linear time for any string, for each string. What's the problem? The problem is that the text itself may be pretty long. So if you have a long text and many strings, then for each string you need to run across the whole text. So this length of the text will be multiplied by the number of strings in your set. So the time complexity will be not actually linear. So it will be linear in some sense, but for the length of the text will be multiplied by the number of strings here. So for each string SI, you need to run across the whole text T. Yeah? So if text is long, then it's not efficient. What we want to do today? Today we kind of want to make an algorithm which finds all these strings in a single pass. So we will try to make a single pass across the whole text and find all these strings at once. That's the plan. What does it mean find all the strings? There may be more problems. So if you just want to output all positions of all strings, then again you may have multiple positions for each string. You may have up to n positions. So if you just want to output all positions, the number of these positions may be like n squared. Like if n is number of strings and m is the number of text, length of the text, then for each string you may have up to m positions in this text. So the output size will be m multiplied by n. So it's too much. But usually you don't want to find all the positions of all the strings. You want to do something like, for example, you may want to find the simplest problem. You just want to check if your text contain at least one of these strings. That's problem one. Find any in T. So we want to find any of the strings in the text. Why you may want to do it? Well, for example, you have some list of bad words and you want to check if your text contain at least one bad word. So you just kind of censorship problem, yeah? So you want to check if your text contains at least one of these banned words. Third problem. Yeah, maybe we'll talk about this later. Okay. That's the first type of problem also today. Second type of problem is for each string you want to find out if this string occurs in the text. For each SI, check that T contains . So the return of this algorithm will be like a list of booleans. For each string, we will return a boolean value, like true or false. The data set contain actually this substring. And maybe we want something more complicated. For example, sometimes we want to calculate the number of times each string occurs in this text. So maybe we want to find the number of times. Is in T. So for each string, we may find the like integer value, like the number of substring in of T equal to this SI. Yeah. And so on. There may be some, and so on. Many other problems about the substrings can be solved using the same approach. Good. That's all. So how to start? What we'll try to do? Now, first you have some list of strings. Let's put some list of strings. Let's say we have strings, let's say AA, BBA, and something ABBA, and something else, let's say BA, AB, and something again BBB. So let's have this list of strings. And we have some text. We want to find these strings in the text. So what we'll try to do? First thing we'll do is we'll build a try over these strings. Like we discussed in previous lecture, we can build an automaton which accepts given strings. It looks like a tree. So we'll build the tree. The root of the tree will be here. And each edge of this tree will contain some letter of your alphabet. Well, in our case, we have just two letters. We have A and B. So each edge will contain some letter A or B. And so we want to have this string A, A, B, B, A. So we make H here A, A here, B, B, A. I will try to make H with letter A to the left and H with letter B to the right, just to make it more clear, right? So this path corresponds to this first string. So this is a terminal node. Yeah, we discussed it in last week. Now let's add all other strings. So let's iterate over all strings and add them to this tree. So we have A, B, B, A. So we have A, then B, then B, then A. So that's the second string. Now we have B, A, A, B. So let's have B, A, B here. And we have B, B, B finally. Again, we discussed it last week, so this data structure is called a try. So let's put it here. It's basically the tree which contains all the strings of the given set. So we just iterate through all strings in this set and put them in this tree greedily. ABBA is the second. ABBA. Right? Nice. So we know how to build this tree. Yes, we can build this tree in linear time. So the time complexity for building this tree is actually the sum of the length of all these strings. So by now we spent, let's put it here, sum of all lengths of the strings. So we can construct this tree in this time complexity. Nice. Is it clear by now? So we discussed it last week, so I just do it very briefly. So go. Now, okay, there are two ways to describe the Aho Corasick algorithm. I'll do both. So there are two ways to think about Aho Corasick algorithm. First way is a little bit more simple, so let's start with this. So what we'll try to do is we will build from this try, we'll build a full automaton. So we'll try to build an automaton which accepts like the strings which contain the given substrings. So what is the idea? So we will try to take this text. So we have this text. And we will read this text from left to right. like in Knut Moritz-Pratt algorithm, like in all algorithms, right? So I just go from left to right and try to find this substring. So if we're standing at some point here, so we already read all these characters from here to here. So which characters we actually need? We don't need all the characters in this prefix, yeah? We only need some last characters here. So we only need some characters which can be later completed to a full string, right? So we only need some characters here if these characters can be completed to some of the strings from this set. So we actually need to have some characters here which are the prefix of one of the strings from this set, right? For example, if we have, let's put some strings. So we have some A, B, and so on. So if we have, if we already read these letters, so which letters we actually need? Let's see. We need this letter A, yes? Because we have strings starting with letter A. Do we need the string B? Yes, do we have a string which starts with BA? Yes, we have a string which starts with BA, so we need this B as well. What about ABA? So we don't have any string which starts with ABA. BABA, no. So we actually only need these two characters. Yeah. Again, it's basically the same thing as we discussed when we discussed Knut Moritz-Pratt algorithm. Actually, you may think about Aho Corasick algorithm as a generalization of the Knut Moritz-Pratt algorithm. It's basically similar to Knut Moritz-Pratt algorithm, but on a tree. Nice. So again, we read all these letters from here to here, but we only need these letters if we want to find these substrings. Yeah. So we can forget everything about here and only take care about these letters. Mm-hmm. Now, these letters are the prefix of one of the strings. Yeah. So each prefix of the given strings may be represented as a vertex of this tree. Okay, again, each node of this tree, if we look on the path from the root to this node, we will get some prefix of one of the strings. And vice versa, so each prefix of the string may be represented as a node in this tree. That's what we'll do. That's the only thing we need to remember. So we only need to remember this prefix, and this prefix will be represented as a node in this tree. So if we're standing here, we know that we read letters B and A, and if we read letters B and A, then we are standing here now. So that will be the current state of this automaton. Mm-hmm. Again, if we stand here, we remember this string represented by this node. So this is the current node of the other automaton. Now, let's talk about transitions. We need to make transitions. Yeah. So we're standing here, we're in this state. So let's read one more letter. So we'll read one more letter in this text. If this letter is, for example, A, if we see letter A, then we will move to this state because we will extend this prefix with letter A, so we'll move to this state. So if we have letter A, we just move here. And we already have actually this transition, yeah? So we have transition from here to here by letter A, so we just use this transition and go here. Mm-hmm. So if I read letter A, I just move to this state. But what happens if I have letter B? If I have letter B, I cannot extend my prefix of letter B because I don't have a transition here, right? I only can extend with letter A. So again, like in prefix function, exactly, we will need to add the maximal possible suffix of the given prefix which can be extended with letter B. So So we know that the last letters were B, A, and B. We know these letters are not important. So for this string B, A, B, we need to find the maximal suffix, which is a prefix of one of these strings S. Yeah. So we need to find the maximal suffix of this string, which actually presents in our tray. Let's do it. So we have this B, A, B is not in the tray, but A, B is in the tray. So if we're standing here in this state and we read letter B, we must go to state A, B. So the next state will be A, B, this state. So if we receive letter B, we go from here to state A, B, to here. Mm-hmm. That's the plan. Now, I will add all the remaining transitions to this automaton and make a full automaton from this try. For example, if I send it here, if I read letter A, and then I read another letter A, I will go here. If I read letter B, I go. So I have both transitions by letter A and by letter B. So that's fine. Here as well, I have transition by A and by B. For this node, I have transition only by letter B. So let's add transition by letter A. So if I have transition by letter A, then I have. So if I'm standing here, it means I have letters AA. If I read another A, then the maximal suffix of this will be AA, right? So AA is the same node here. So if I am standing in this state and I read another letter A, I must stay in the same state. So I will just make transition from here to itself by letter A. And so on. Let's just add all the remaining transitions. For example, here I don't have transition by A, so if I read A, B, and then A, I must go to B, A, right? From here, if I read B, B, and then A, then I have B, B, A, maximal suffix is B, A. From here, if I read A, A, B, and then A, so if I have A, A, B, and then read letter A, then what will be the maximal suffix? So A, B, A is not in the tray. B, A is in the tray. So the maximal suffix will be B, A. So if I'm standing here and I read letter A, I must go to state B, A. State B, A is here. So from here to here, I need to make a transition, oop, like this. And so on. I will stop here. So you got the point. So let's just add all the remaining transitions and build the full automaton. Nice. You forgot to say everything is clear. Okay. So that's how the algorithm works. The algorithm will basically build all these remaining transitions, and so in the end you will have the full automaton. Nice. Now to the interesting part. I want to build these transitions efficiently. So if you just do it, if you just make some naive approach, so you just have this current state, yeah, this current state. Oh, let's state. So I want to make a transition. Let's put it here. I want to make a transition from state V by letter C. What does it mean? No, we'll go through problems later. Yeah, that's just the structure. We'll solve all these problems a little bit later. Yeah, by now it's not clear how to solve these problems using this structure, but we'll do it. So if we want to transition from state V, so we have this state V. This state V corresponds to some string. Yeah, we will add this letter C. Then we need to find the maximal suffix, which presents in our tray, and move transition to this state. Yeah. Yeah. So. Now, if you just try to do it just in some naive approach, so just if you just do it, just take this string, iterate through all its suffixes. For each suffix, you try to add this letter C, check if this string is in your try, and so on. That's too slow, because for the number of strings is linear, so for each string you need to iterate through all these suffixes, that's another linear, and then you check if this string is in your try, it's another linear time, so it will look like n cube. You don't want to have n cube, so we'll do it fast. How to do it fast? It's pretty much the same as we did in the Knuth-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. So what we'll do, we will construct some additional links in this string. And these links do the same thing as the prefix function in the Knuth-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. But to make it a little bit more complicated, they're called suffix links. For each node, we will build a suffix link. What is a suffix link? Suffix link is the following thing. So you have this, let's suffix of v. We will take the string corresponding to this state v. So this state v is some state of this try. So for each state, there is some string. Yeah? So there is some string corresponding to this state v. And we will just find the maximal suffix of this string, which is also in your try. So this maximal string will be the suffix link. Again, it's pretty much the same as in Knuth-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. In Knuth-Morris-Prandtl algorithm, we try to find for each prefix, we find the maximal suffix, which is also a prefix, right? And here we do the same thing. We will find for each prefix of all these strings. So each state is a prefix of one of the strings. Yeah. So for each prefix of all these strings, we'll find the maximal suffix of this prefix, which is also a prefix of one of these strings. Yeah. So it's pretty much the same, but you have multiple strings. Yeah. So you may have suffix of one string and prefix of another string. It's fine. So but for each prefix which is in your try, you will find the maximal prefix or suffix of this prefix, which is also in your try. Well, for example, let's build some suffix links. Let's use some more colors here. Oh. Well, for example, let's go from here. So this state, so for this state, you have string ABB. Yeah. What is the maximal suffix of ABB, which is also in this try? So if you have string ABB, then it has suffix BB. Suffix BB is in your try, it's here. So we will put suffix link from here to here. And like, let's do it like this. So, oh, you cannot read these colors. Let me use some other color. Let's use this pink. Yeah, it's a little bit more visual. Okay. So from this state, we will put suffix link to this state, and so on. So let's build some more suffix links. For example, I don't know which one's better. For example, from here, you have string BAAB. So the maximal suffix of this string is AAB. So you put suffix link from here to BAAB. For example, from here, you have string AABBA. So ABBA. ABBA is in, so it's here. Okay. That's boring. Let's do something interesting. For example, from here, you have string ABBA. BBA is not in the try. BA is in the try. So the maximal suffix of this string, which is in the try, is BA. So we need to put suffix link from here to string BA. To here. Mm-hmm. Got the point. So, again, let's go from top to bottom. So for these two states, the suffix link will go to the root, because so here you have string A, the maximal suffix of A is empty string, so you have suffix link to the root. From here you have AA, the maximal suffix is A, here you have AB, maximal suffix is B, and so on. So you have something like this. Yeah? For each state, you have a link to the maximal suffix of this string. Now, what about the root? The root doesn't have any suffix link. It's like in the Knut-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. In Knut-Morris-Prandtl algorithm, we don't have prefix function for an empty string. Here, the same thing. Root is kind of special nodes. Root is a node which corresponds to empty string. For an empty string, you don't have any prefixes other than the string itself. So, for the root, we'll not calculate suffix link. We'll calculate suffix link for all nodes except the root. That's all. That's all we need. So, what will we do? We will calculate two arrays. You may think about this as an array. Yes. So, we'll calculate this array of transitions and this array of suffix links. And we will do it for all the nodes of this tree. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's all preparations. Now to the algorithm. Let's go. So let's take some node. Let's try to calculate some suffix or some transition. So you have node V. And you want to calculate transition by some character C. Yeah? So you want to calculate this delta of V and C. What does it mean? Again, you have this string. Let me draw it. So you have this string V. You add this character C. And you want to find the maximal suffix which is in your train. So if you already have a transition here down, if this string V plus C is in the tray, then you just move the transition, then you just left the transition. So if you have the transition from here to one of the children, then it's already done. So if you don't have this transition, it means that this string V plus C is not in the tray. So this whole string is not in the tray. So we need to take some suffix which is not the whole string. Yeah? So what we need to do, we need to find something like this. So we need to find some suffix of this string which is in the tray. Mm-hmm. Again, we'll do it exactly like in Knut-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. Let's state. So this last letter is C. And this thing is some suffix of the string V. Mm-hmm. So if we want to make transition from V by the character C, we need to find the maximal suffix of V, which can be extended by this letter C. Mm-hmm. We can just will go left to right. Yes, we can actually. That's the like I explained earlier. There are two ways to think about Aho Corasick algorithm. I think it's the easier way to think about it, but we'll go to your solution later. Yes, you can actually, the classical Aho Corasick algorithm doesn't use these transitions, and we will do it later. It's the first version. We will get rid of these transitions later. You can do it, yeah. That's right. You can build only suffix links, and that's also possible in linear time. We will do it in I don't know, in some time. So I need to find the maximal suffix of V which can be extended to letter C. So how to iterate all suffixes of the string? Again, we will do it exactly the same like we did in the Knut-Morris-Prandtl algorithm. So we can go from string V to its maximal suffix, just following the suffix link. So we will go from here to here by the suffix link. It was pink, so let's paint it pink as well. So we can follow this pink link and go to the maximal suffix of the string S. Yeah. Now, if this maximal string can be extended to letter C, then we found the maximal string which can be maximal suffix which can be extended. If not, we go to the next suffix. So we go to here, to the next suffix, and so on. So if we just follow this path of suffix links, we will iterate over all suffixes of this given string by decreasing order by the length of this string. So if you take the first suffix link, you will find the maximal suffix. Now you take the next suffix link, you will find the next maximal suffix, and so on. So you go from here to here to here to here, and you will iterate over all suffixes of this string. And you just stop when you find this the character C. So you just follow this until you find some character C here. So when you find some suffix which can be extended to letter C, you just say that this is your transition. So this will be the transition from V to by C. Mm-hmm. What if we don't have any suffixes here? It's possible that we iterate over all suffixes of the string and go to the empty suffix and still don't have any transition by character C. Then we'll just put the transition to the root. Again, if we iterate over all suffixes and we cannot extend any suffix of letter C, it means there is no suffix which contain this letter C, right? So the answer will be empty suffix. Mm-hmm. Again, it is the same like in Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm. In Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm, we iterate over all prefix functions until we find something which is equal to your current character. And if you don't find anything, then you make the prefix function equal to zero, right? Here we do the same thing. So if you iterate over all these suffixes and don't find this letter C, then you just stop and say that the transition must go to the root. Mm-hmm. Nice. So if you just implement it like this, unfortunately it will be too slow. So if you just do it like this, again, like we discussed in previous lecture, we did the same bug. So if you just iterate all these links, the time complexity will be too slow, unfortunately, because it may happen that you may have a big chain of these suffix links, and for each character here, you need to follow all these steps and just don't find any characters here. So we'll do the same trick as in the previous lecture. We'll follow one suffix link here. And for this suffix link, we already know the transition by character C. So we will just go to this suffix link, make one transition by this suffix link. So and for this maximal suffix, we will use the precalculated transition by the character C. So when we calculate the transition for this suffix, we already did all this work. Yeah. So we already did all this when we calculated the transition for this suffix. So we already know what will be the final result. It will be just the transition from suffix links of V by the same character. Yeah. So we'll just use this precalculated transition. That's the whole plan. Let's write some code. So what will I do? I will iterate all nodes. Let's fix it later. So we will iterate all nodes of our tray. For each node, we'll iterate all. Let's make some sense. So we need to calculate suffix links. Let's put it here. Let's put it here for later use. And then we'll iterate all characters. Now for each character, if there is no transition, if there's no transition, then we just use this transition from the suffix link. Mm-hmm. Again, we want to find the transition from this string by this character C. So we need to follow this chain of suffix link and find the closest suffix which has the transition. But we can follow one suffix link and then use the result from this string. So the transition from V by C will be equal to the transition of the suffix link by capital C. Again, it's very easy algorithm. That's all. That's how we calculate transitions. Now, how to calculate suffix links? Let's see, you want to calculate suffix link. Suffix link is the maximal suffix which is in your train. Yeah. The same thing like in Knuth-Morris path algorithm. Again, how we calculate prefix function in Knuth-Morris path algorithm? Look at the last character. So we have this last character. We have this last character here. And what we need to do is to find, is to take the string one character shorter, we need to take this string, yeah, without this x. What will be the string of v without the last character? What node corresponds to this string? Again, I have this string, yeah, this string. I want to remove this last character and look at this string, one character shorter. What node of the try will correspond to this shorter string? Parent node, right? So this shorter string will be just the parent of node B. Yeah. Now, what we need to do is we need to add this character X to the parent of the node B. Yeah. But if we just add X to this parent, we will go back to this node. So we need to find some suffix of the parent. So we want to find this. So this string will be a suffix of the parent. So we need to find the suffix of a parent which can be extended with letter X. Mm-hmm. So what we'll do, we'll find the maximal suffix of parent. So this will be the suffix link of parent. So we'll take the maximal possible suffix of the parent and then try to add this letter X to this maximal possible suffix using these precalculated transitions. So we'll make a transition from the suffix link of the parent of V by the character X. So what is X? X is the character corresponding to this letter. Let's say H of V. So this is the character which we used when we go to, from parent to this node, right? Let me draw it here. So we have transition from this V, from the parent of V, and this character is th of V. Yeah. So again, what we do here? We go to the parent node, so we remove last character here. Then we find the largest possible suffix of this parent. And then we extend this maximal suffix with the letter X using these precalculated transitions. That's almost it. Mm-hmm. Easy algorithm. That's the whole part. Now the final thing, this part. I want to build suffix links and transitions using some other suffix links and transitions. Yeah. So I'm building an array using the values in the same array. This should be done carefully because you need to make sure that when you use this values, they are already calculated. So all these values we used here must be calculated before the value in the node B. Mm-hmm. So we need to build this we need to find these values in some specific order. Yeah. So in such order that these. So, okay. Let me see. So we use it here. We use it here. We use it here. Here, and so on. So all these values must be calculated before the value in the node V. Have any ideas about which order we need to use to make sure that these values was calculated before the value we need to calculate? If you have a solution, okay. So let's just calculate these values from top to bottom by increasing the length of this string. So all these operations move to some shorter string. Mm-hmm. So length of the suffix link is always shorter than the length of the string because it is some suffix. Length of the parent is shorter because it's a parent. It's one character shorter. So all these values we used belong to some shorter strings. So let's just build this from top to bottom, layer by layer. Yeah. So by increasing the number of characters in the string. So let's. So we just run breadth first search algorithm from the root, like extended breadth first search algorithm, and just iterate over layers and then use this code just to calculate the value of suffix function and transitions. That's all. That's the whole Aho Corasick algorithm. That's the shortest implementation I know. Nice. Now, what is time complexity? What is the time complexity of this thing? It's obviously linear. Yeah. So we just iterate over all the nodes. For each node, we iterate all the characters. So the time complexity will be number of nodes. So number of nodes is no more than sum of all the lengths multiplied by the size of the alphabet. Oh, I use sigma twice again. Okay, sorry. So this sigma is the sum, and this sigma is the length of the alphabet. Okay. So we just multiply the total length of all string because the number of nodes in this tree is actually at most the sum of lengths of all the strings. Yeah. So I just multiply the size of this tree by the number of characters in my alphabet. Mm-hmm. Now, how to use this? Let's go to the problems. Let's go back to the problems. So, how to solve these problems? What you will do? You will use this automaton and put this string as an input to this automaton. So, again, you go from left to right in this text T. Let's just erase something. Erase something here and this. So you have a text. You just go from left to right. Mm-hmm. Each time you add one more character, so you have your current state. You have your current state. Each time you add one more character and move to the next state using your transition array. Yeah. So you just again you have some character. You just look at this array and find the next transition and move to the next state, and so on. Now to the interesting part. So how to solve these problems? Let's start from the first problem. We need to find some string in the text. Okay, how to find out that they actually found one of the strings in the text? So imagine you build all this stuff. Yeah. Now you go from left to right. Each time you know the current state of your automaton. How to find out that you find one of these strings? In Heroes 6, right? Well, first of all, let's see. If at some point you are in one of these terminal states, when you definitely find one of the strings, yeah? So, for example, if you're standing in this state, if this is your current state, it means that the last characters you saw was B A A B. So if at some point your current state is one of these terminal states, then you find one of the strings from your set. Mm-hmm. Is it the only case or not? Well, it turns out it's not enough. Let me draw some smaller example. For example, you have strings like, let's say, strings. Let's have something small. Let's say A A B B A, and string A B B. Let's have just two strings. So what will happen? You have string. You don't need this A. Let's move this A. Doesn't make sense. So let's have just two strings. Yeah, ABB, A and BB. So you have A, B, B, A, and string BB. This is terminal. This is terminal. Okay, let's just use this algorithm to build all the transitions. Okay, let's just show how this algorithm works on this for this try. So again, you go from top to bottom. Each time you just implement this, so you execute this. So for this A, you make suffix link to here. For B, suffix link to here. For this, you need to have transition by letter A. So to make transition by letter A, you go to the suffix link, then make transition to A. So you have transition here. From here, you have transition by A, so you move to suffix link, then transition by A, so it will be moved here. Here, if you have letter A, let's calculate suffix link. Let's calculate suffix link for this node. So you go to the parent, then to the suffix link, then use the same character as here, so you follow letter B. So your suffix link will go here. From here, you take parent, suffix link, then the same character as this. So you go here. Now transitions. From here, you have transition by letter A. You move here, and then use this transition by letter A. So if you have letter A, you go here. And so on. From here, by letter A, you go for the letter A, so it goes here, A. By B, you go here, B. Here, suffix link. So you take parent, suffix link, same character, B. So you follow here. Transition by B will be usually here, and then B, so it will be there. Here, suffix link will go to take parent here, then the same character, so for A. So we go here, it's A. That's A. A. Again, suffix link from here, so you go to parent, then suffix link, then use the same character. So we go here. No, suffix link. So suffix link will go here. Now transitions. By A you go here, then by A use them here. By B you go here, then by B you go here. So you want here. That's all. So you build this automaton. It looks scary, but it's not. Now, again, yeah, you already find what the problem is, but I'll do. So, what will happen if you take string A, B, B? If you take string A, B, B, then you just start from the root and go here, here, and here. So you will end up in this state. So your current state will be A, B, B, so it will be here. Whew. That's all. Now, what's the problem is? The problem is we actually find the string BB. Yeah? So the string BB is here. And string BB is in our set. Yeah. But this state is not terminal. Mm-hmm. So it may happen that you find some string, but your current state is not terminal. Why it happened? Because we have some longer prefix. So we have this prefix BB, but we also have some longer prefix. So this prefix ABB is also here. Yeah? So we remember on the longest prefix. And this longest prefix may not be the terminal prefix. Mm-hmm. So we have string BB, but we have some longer prefix, which is not terminal. It may happen. So how to solve this problem? Quite easy. So how to find out your current state is actually need to be a terminal state. So we have your current state. So your current state corresponds to some prefix. You find the string when your string is the suffix of your current state. So this is some string SI. This is your current state. Yeah? So your string must be a suffix of your current state. What are the suffixes of a state? These are all the states which are accessible by these suffix links. So you need to follow all these suffix links. So this is the current state. This is your current state, yeah? So you need to follow these suffix links, and if you have some terminal state reachable by these suffix links, then here you actually need to stop, because here you find your string. So again, if you're standing in this state, it means that your current state is some prefix. This node is a terminal node, so it corresponds to some string, some string SI. Okay. So this string SI is some suffix of suffix of suffix. So it is a suffix of my current node. So it is here. Mm-hmm. So we actually find the string SI in the text. So we need to stop. If we solve the first problem. Yeah? So if we just need to find any string in the text. So but when we reach this state, we need to stop. And say that we actually find the string SI. Right? And so how to do it? Let's mark all the states such that we can reach some terminal state from this state as terminal as well. For example, let's make it 1 and 2. So in this node we find string 1, in this node we find string 2. So from this node we can reach this node using this suffix link. So if we're standing here, we also find the string 2. So let's mark it as well. So let's mark this string as 2, this state as 2. That's all. that's all. So what we'll need to do, again, what we need to do? We need to mark all the nodes in this path as terminal nodes with the same string as here. So all these nodes also must be terminal nodes, because we can reach these terminal nodes using this suffix link. How to do it in linear time? Okay, this is a simple tree problem. Can you solve it? I want to do it in linear time. I want to, in linear time, to find all the terminal nodes in this graph. BFS, dynamic programming. Yeah. There are two ways of thinking about this. You may do it like this. You may just follow all the nodes from top to bottom, again, using the same BFS. And for each node, if its suffix link is already marked, then mark this node as well. So we'll just go from layer by layer. So first we'll see for this node, this is terminal, so we'll mark this node. Then we'll find for this node, this is terminal, so we'll mark this node, and so on. So we'll just go from top to bottom, and we'll mark all the nodes we need to mark. Huh? Another way to think about this is tree approach. So basically, if you look only at the suffix links, you will find that suffix links actually form another tree. So there is a tree of suffix links. So again, every node has a suffix link. So we can build a tree. So suffix link is a parent of the current node, something like this. Yep. So if you remove everything but suffix links, you will have some tree. Yeah, it's easy to see because each node has only one suffix link. So if we say this node is a parent, we will have some tree. So you can apply any tree algorithm to this tree. For example, here what we need to do is if some node is terminal, then the whole subtree of this tree is terminal. So if you take a node of this tree, then this subtree is the set of nodes from which we can access this node using suffix links. So if some node is terminal, then we need to mark the whole subtree as terminal. So we'll simply mark everything in this subtree. And you can do it using some DFS over this tree. So you can build explicitly this tree and then run simple DFS to mark everything which should be marked. It's another way to think about it. Basically the same thing. No, here you do the same thing, you just do the dynamic programming. This is another way to think about dynamic programming on tree. You can do dynamic programming layer by layer in BFS fashion, yeah? Or you can do it just using DFS over this tree. That's the same thing, okay? The only idea is your parent to be calculated before your node, yeah? The same thing. Mm-hmm. So again, the whole algorithm to solve the first problem. So to solve the first problem, what we need to do? First, we build a tree in linear time. Then we calculate all the transitions and suffix links. Again, in linear time, multiplied by the size of the alphabet. Yeah? If the alphabet is small, it's good enough. Yeah? What to do if alphabet is big, we'll talk about in a few moments. Okay. Now, you just take your string T and read your text character by character and remember your current state. If your current state is one of these terminal states, then you find one of the strings from its set. Ta-da. That's all. What would be time complexity? Again, time complexity to build everything. This is linear. So you can build this tree in linear time, you can build these links in linear time, you can mark all the nodes which need to be marked in linear time and so on. So all the pre-calculations are linear. Yeah? Now, when you read the string T, each time you just add one more character and move along that some transitions. So each move is a constant time. So again, it's linear by the size of the text. So the total time complexity, let's put it here, will be the sum of lengths of the given strings multiplied by the alphabet plus the size of the text. Good. Let's try to solve all other problems. So this is the first problem. Now, what about the second problem? Let's do it the same way. So we will try to find for each string if this string occurs in this text. Again, let's draw what happened. So you have this text. You have your text like this. And in this text you have one of your strings. So for example, here you have one of the strings. What will happen when you move to this position? When you move to this position, your current state will be some prefix which is at least size of this string, because this string is a prefix, yes? So your current state will have then at least this. So your current state will be something like this. So you find string S if at some point your current state is something, so your string is suffix of this current state. Yep. So what we'll do? There are many ways to do it. The easiest way maybe is just to let's mark all the states we visit during this trip. So we have this string, so let's have some string. Let's have AA, BA, BB, BA. Too much. Sorry. I want to find a small example, but I don't want to enter all these characters. So you have this text. In this text, you just go from left to right each time you remember the current state and just mark all the state you visited during this process. So you start from the root. So you start here. Mark the root. Then you have letter A. So you move here, mark this state. Then you have letter A, so you move from here to the same thing, mark it again. Then you have letter B, so you move here. Then you have letter B. Then you have letter B as again, so you move from here to here. And then you have letter A, so you move back here. So we just marked all the states we visit during this trip. Yeah. So all these states At some point, current was equal to this current state was equal to one of these states. Now, let's mark all the suffixes of this string. So for all these marked states, let's mark all these suffixes. So we'll mark all the strings which are the suffixes of the current state at some point. So at some point we have this current state, we want to mark all the suffixes so we'll know that we visited this string S. Yeah? So we look at all these marked states. Again, to do the same thing like we just did. We need suffix things. Let's use pink. If this state is marked, we also need to mark all its suffixes. Because when we have this current state, we also visited all the suffixes of this state, right? So we go from here and mark all the suffixes using these suffix links. Absolutely the same. Again, there are two ways to do it. You can do it using your BFS, but you need to do it from bottom to top. So you just take this Q from the BFS, reverse it, and go from bottom to top, and just propagate these marks up to the tree. Or you can build this tree. You can build tree of suffix links. Then you need to mark the node if you have at least one marked node in its subtree. So for each node, you need to find if there is at least one marked node in its subtree. You can do it using depth of search in the tree. As you wish. Both approaches are linear. So, okay, again, what you do? You iterate through all characters of your string. Maintain your current character, your current state. Mark all the states you visited. Then propagate these marks using the suffix links. Now you mark all the strings, which actually are the substrings of T. Because each string, which is substring of T, will be the suffix of some prefix. Mm-hmm. And we just marked all the strings, which are the suffixes of all the strings we visited. So we marked everything. Mm-hmm. Now, to check if your string S is in the string T, you just take this string, find the corresponding state, and check if this state is marked. If this state is marked, then this string was a suffix of something which you visited, and so on. Mm-hmm. So you have the string in the text. That's all. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And finally, let's solve the final problem. Let's calculate the number of times we visit each string. So let's remove this, remove this, remove this, remove this. Well, again, let's have something longer. Let's have A, B, B, A, A, B, A, B, B. Let's see, B, 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 A. Some long text. So let's have some text. I want to find the number of times I find the string in this text. Again, what happened if I find the string in the text? So if I have the string BB, for example, it's here, here, and here. So I have it three times. If I have string in the text, it means that when I visit the last character of the string, my current state is something. So my string is suffix of this. Mm-hmm. Do the same thing, but we'll not make the booleans, but integers, yes. We'll calculate the number of times we visit each state. Yeah. Absolutely the same thing. Again, I will put this string to this automaton and calculate the number of times I visit each state. So I start from the root again. So I have letter A, so here's 1. Then I have letter A, I move here, so it's 2. I'm standing here, so now it's B, I move here. Now another B, I move here. Now it's A, so from here, I move here. Now again A, so I move here, so it's 3. Now B, A, yes, B, A, B, okay, like B, then A, then B, okay. Okay, this, it's a little bit messy. Where was I? Here, right? And now BBA. B, and then A here again. That's all. So I just made a counter for each node. And I just calculated the number of times I visited this node during this process. Polylog of T? No. You need at least to read this text, right? Yeah. So at least you need to read this text at least once. Sorry, I believe it can be done faster than the length of the text. So this plus t is kind of important. You need to read this text, so you can get rid of this. Now, that's all. So again, I just iterate over characters of this set. Each time I have some current state, I just increment the counter in this state. Now for each state, I know the number of times I visited this state. So the number of times I have this string s is the number of times, total number of times, I am in some node such that s is the suffix of this node. So if I have some string s, I visit the string s when I am in some state from which s is reachable using this suffix string. So I need to have all these states. So I need to take all this subtree and just take the sum of all the values in this subtree. Again, if at any point I am in one of these states, it means I have some string, so s is the suffix of this string. So I have string s in my text. Mm-hmm. So to find the total number of times I see the string s in the text, I just need to take sum of all these values. It is a sum in a subtree. You can calculate it again using dynamic programming on a tree. Or you can go from bottom to top and propagate these values up. Again, you just take your current value and add it to your suffix link. So you can go from bottom to top and propagate it up. Same thing. I'm not sure what you're talking about. We can run this MLGrim for multiple texts. So if you have multiple strings T, we can run it multiple times. So it will be, so this is time for pre-calculation of all this automaton. Ah, you mean we don't need the whole automaton if this text is short. Yeah, I believe you can do it using some tree algorithms. Something like heavy light decomposition in this tree or something like this. Yeah, I believe if you have many small texts and you just want to, for each text to do something, you can, yeah. Yeah, I believe you can apply some tree algorithms to this, yeah. No, that's all basically. That's the whole. So we just solved all these problems using this technique in almost linear time. Almost, I mean, by we multiply it by the size of the alphabet. But if your alphabet is small, if you like have two letters A and B, that's fine. If the alphabet is big, that's not good, but good enough by now. Yeah. Now, let's do the final trick. So that's the easiest implementation of the Aho Corasick algorithm I know. So it's definitely usable when your size of the alphabet is small. What happens if the size of your alphabet is big? If the size of the alphabet is big, then actually calculating all these transitions is too much. So the total number of these transitions is too big. We don't want to calculate all these transitions. What you can do, you can avoid calculating these transitions. You can calculate only suffix links and calculate these transitions on fly. So what you can do? Okay, the most classical, that's like the modern version. So the classical Aho Corasick algorithm doesn't use these transitions. So let's build only suffix links. We'll do it in the same way like we did in the Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm. Again, it's like generalization of the Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm. So we will calculate suffix link in the same way we built a prefix function in the Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm. Yeah? So how to calculate suffix links if we don't have any transitions pre-calculated? So we have this again. So we have string B. We want to calculate the suffix length. Yeah. Suffix length is a maximal suffix of this thing. So we want to find the maximal suffix of string V, which is in our try. How can we do it? Using the same approach like in clockwork pipeline. So we will iterate all suffixes of string V, of the parent, and try to add the last character to this parent. So I will remove the last character here, take the parent of V, and then iterate all suffixes of this parent. Until I find something which can be extended with letters x. Now this string will be my suffix length. Yeah, absolutely the same like in Knut Morris Pratt. So, okay. Let's implement this. It's actually easier. It's much easier than it looks. Okay, let's say that. Say P is a parent of V and X is the character. Yeah. Again, it's the character which is character which is on this. This is P, this parent of V, and this H contains the character. Yeah, like we did before. Yeah. Now, I will follow this suffix link until I find this. Okay, let me write it like as close as possible to the Knut Morris Pratt algorithm. So, let's say K is the suffix link of the parent. Now, I will iterate all suffixes until I find something which can be extended with X. Or if I run to the root and then, so at some point you will run to the root and then you don't have a suffix link. So while K is not null and there is no transition for by character X, it's just null. Okay, just for space. That's not empty set. This is just a null. Okay. So while I don't have a transition, I just move to the next suffix. Now, in the end, if K is null, it means I iterate all suffixes, I can't extend anything, so I need to make suffix link to the root. Then suff of V will equal to root. Else, I just follow this transition and go to the child. So, suff of V will be KX. That's all. In Knut Morris Pratt algorithm, we actually avoid this if, since we made the prefix function of 0 equal to minus 1, we just always make plus 1, yeah, so it's... Here we kind of need to have a special case when you have an MC, so you follow all these links and go beyond this empty string. So in Knut Morris Pratt, we just have minus 1, plus 1, and go to 0. Here we got something similar. So if we go to minus 1, it means we have beyond the empty string, so we need to make the link to the zero. If not, we just follow this link and go there. Yeah. That's all. I claim the time complexity is linear. So, okay, that'll be the final thing that we'll prove today. Let's prove that the time complexity of this algorithm is actually linear. Sum of all these. Walk if k is null, but can... No, if k is null, it means we actually we follow all the links, go to the empty string, and then try to have an even smaller suffix. Yeah? It means we iterate all possible suffixes and then go from this. So from the root, I have a suffix link to null. So something like this. So if k equals 2 null, it means I go beyond this point. So, so I'm here. It means I have no suffix which can be extended again. Now, I claim that the time complexity is still linear. Why is it linear? Well, because let's try to calculate the total time complexity of calculating all the nodes along some string. So let's try, let's take some string S. Let's take this first string and try to calculate the total time complexity for these nodes. Let's see what's going on. So when we iterate all these nodes, for each time, we have something linear plus this while. So let's calculate the total number of iterations of this while loop. Again, like a Knut Morris Rat algorithm, in this while loop, we go from string k to something smaller than string k. So here, the length of string k is decreasing. So each time we follow the suffix link, we go from some node to some node above. Yeah. But what happens when we move from one transition to the next transition? So if we compare this node and this node, so when we calculate this bottom node, we actually take k as the suffix link of the parent, right? And here we just extend it by one. So when we move from one node to the next node, we extend this k by one. So when we go from one node to the parent to the child, so k will be extended by one. It's not, no, not k, but length of the k. So when you move from the parent to the child, again, what happened? You set the suffix link as this transition from k to x. So here actually. You extend the k by one character, then put it in a suffix array, and then take it back here as a suffix of your parent. Yeah. So here you put it string of length k plus one, and then take it back as k. So if you sum all the time complexities for all these nodes, you will have a linear time complexity in total. Yeah. And now let's just take sum of all these strings. So for each string, time complexity will be linear. So total complexity will be linear by the sum of these strings. That's a little bit tricky because time complexity is linear by the total length of all the strings, but it may be not linear by the size of the try. So it's possible that your try is small, but the total length of all strings is big. For example, if you have something like this, yeah, and something. And here you have many strings. Then you have n states, but the total size of all these strings is n square, right? So we have n strings, each string has length n. So the total time complexity will depend on the total length of all these strings, not on the size of the size of your try. So it may happen you have a small try, but the total length of all strings is big. It may happen. So for example, in this graph, the time complexity will be n squared, yeah, right? Yeah. So you have n states here and n states here. Each time you follow, each time when you calculate suffix link for these states, you will need to find, you follow all this chain of suffix links to here. So you take the, no, again. You might have suffix links like this. So when you calculate suffix link to these states, you go here and then follow all this chain. Then for this state, you take this state and follow all this chain and so on. So the time complexity may be quadratic by the size of the try, but it will be linear by the total length of all strings. That's important. Did I forget something? Any more questions? So it will be fast if it's very small. Yes, the first algorithm is linear, but actually by the size of the try. No, it's actually it's easy to see. I erased the code, but it's very easy code. It's linear by the size of the tree, but it is multiplied by the size of the alphabet. Yeah. So if you have small tree but it's n small alphabet, that code may be better. Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, how to use this code? So when we discussed how to raise problems, we actually used all these transitions. We actually don't need these transitions. Let's raise the transitions and leave only the suffix links. So to solve all these problems, it's actually sufficient to have only suffix links. How to do it using suffix links? The same way. Okay, so we need to erase this again, and this, oh, like this. Let's leave only the suffix links. I claim this enough. So you can solve all these three problems using only suffix links. Well, how to do it? The same way. Each time you maintain the current state, but you don't have the transitions, so you could calculate its transition on the go. So you start from the current state. So you start from state here. Now you have letter A, so you go here. Now you have letter A, so you go here. So from here, you need... So you're staying here, yeah? Now you have letter A, so you need to find the transition by letter A. How to find the transition by letter A? You don't have the transition here. So you follow the suffix links until you find the transition by the letter A. So you follow the suffix link, and then move transition by A. So again, you're standing here. Now you read the letter B, so we go here. Now again, you read B to B, so we go here, and go here, so we get here, here. Now again, you need to make a transition by the letter A. You don't have transition by letter A. So you move the suffix link until you find transition by letter A. So from here, you move here. Again, you don't have a transition by letter A. So you follow the next suffix link and so on. Here we have a transition by letter A, so this will be your current state. So again, if you're standing here, then this was your current state, A, B, B, yeah. So this is your current state, and you want to add letter A. You just follow the suffix links, and you will find all the suffixes, and find the longest one which can be extended letter A. So you follow the suffix link, you go from here to here, so your stand will be A. You try to add A to this A, you don't have this transition, so you follow the next suffix link, go to the root, so your string will be empty string, and try to add A to the empty string. You can add A to the empty string, so you go here, and this will be your next current state. Again, time complexity will be linear, because each time you follow the suffix link, you decrease the length of the string. So when you add one more character, you extend it by one. When you move to along the suffix link, you decrease the length. So you can't decrease it more than n times. So total time complexity n will be linear. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a little bit more classical version of this Aho Corasick algorithm. Mm-hmm. Okay, enough for today.